Hello viewers, welcome to online classes day 17th. We are discussing the topic respiratory system. Let us recapitulate what are the topics learned in last class. We completed a mechanism of respiration in which external internal respiration is present among them. The external respiration we finished. In the part of external respiration, the phases of external respiration and the mechanism of inspiration and path of inspiration and mechanism of expiration, path of expression, all these things we learned in earlier class. Today, in the part of 8, today we are going to learn one more topic. Before that, related to external respiration, you have to remember these points compulsory as in entrance examination. So you observe these points. The healthy person can breathe about 14 to 18 times per minute. So it is very, very important, useful for calculations of various kinds of problems. So you have to remember, the healthy person can breathe about 14 to 18 times per minute. In some textbooks, it given as 12 to 16 times. So the average value is 14 to 18 times per minute followed. Right, next, the respiration, the external respiration, the breathing rate is being more in children comparatively with adults. In children, the breathing rate is more because the metabolic rate in children high, require more oxygen to them. That's why breathing rate also more in children. Followed? Yes. Right. Next, the mammals have negative pressure breathing that facilitates simultaneous eat and breathe. So, comparatively with other group of vertebrates, example fishes, amphibians, reptiles, eels, comparatively with other group with members of other group vertebrates, in case of mammals, negative pressure breathing is present. That's why automatically we can inhale the air at the time of breath also. So it is also one important. And next one, you observe, if we compared the respiratory movements pattern during external respiration in females and males. In females, the rib movement plays major role in breathing. That is also called thoracic breathing. Follow? So you observe in females, the rib movement, the ribcage movement predominant at the time of ventilation. Ribs are plays key role in them. So that is called thoracic breathing. If we observe the same thing in males, the abdominal breathing is predominant. The abdominal breathing is more in males. The diaphragm shows major movement. Followed? So that is abdominal breathing. So concern to ventilation, concern to external respiration. In females, thoracic breathing major, and in males, abdominal breathing is major. Follow? Right. Next, let us discuss one more concept related to human respiratory system, that is pulmonary volumes and capacities. Followed? Right. Students, listen here. What are pulmonary volume? What is mean pulmonary volume? Pulmonary volume is nothing but, it is a quantity of air, the amount of air, volume of air that runs, that passes during ventilation, during breathe, followed. So the volume, that is pulmonary volume, the quantity of air, the amount of air, how much runs in our respiratory tract during ventilation. So it is measured by a specialized device that is called spirometer. Follow students? Yes. You observe this visual? The spirometer is there. So the working pattern also you observe. It is used for clinical assessment of lung functions. Follow? So what is the purpose of spirometer? For example, any malfunctions are reported, noticed in respiratory system, the abnormality of physiological functions of lungs to be assessed by the spirometer. Suppose, are there any deviation in volume of air, the quantity of air? So automatically that reflects the malfunction of the respiratory system. Right? Next. So this spirometer, when we operate this spirometer, at that time it displays a graphical representation. So the graphical representation between pulmonary volumes and time, towards x-axis time, towards y-axis pulmonary volumes. Pulmonary volume nothing but quantity of air, amount of air, remember. So the graphical representation between pulmonary volume and time displayed by the spirometer called spirometry. By observing the curves of this graphical representation, automatically we diagnose the malfunctions of the respiratory system, right? So the graphical representation of pulmonary volume, or representation between pulmonary volume and time, that produced by this spirometer called spirometry, it also called as spirogram. One more term is there. Remember students, it is also called spirogram. Followed? You observe this is spirogram visual. Towards y-axis, the pulmonary volume, the amount of air given in milliliter from 0 to 6000. Towards x-axis, time plotted, and you observe the curve, upward and downward curves are there. You see, upward and downward curves are there. You observe yellow color middle bar, the curves are moderate, and brown color bar, high peak, upward curves are there. Yellow, green color bar you observe, downward curves are there. So the upward curves, remember, the upward curves represents the volume of air that consent to inspiration. Upward curves always represents volume of air consent to inspiration. You observe the downward curve is there. The downward curve represents the volume of air consent to expiration. Followed? So two variants of curves are there. Upward curves are present and downward curves are present. The upward curves represents the volume of air consent to inspiration. The downward curves represents the volume of air consent to expiration. Followed? Right, students? This is spirogram. Right, next. We'll discuss pulmonary volume definition. What is pulmonary volume? The volume of air that received, hold and expel during breath in different conditions of persons called pulmonary volume. Followed? So the person never remains same condition always. Sometimes the person may active in condition. For example, we doing vigorous exercise, at that time we are active in condition. Our muscles contracts rapidly, require more oxygen, breathing rate increases, so metabolic rate increases. So at that time our condition is different. The intake volume of air also different, consuming oxygen also different. For example, we are in resting condition, so automatically the ventilation rate reduce. Sleeping condition, drowsy condition. So you observe different patterns of condition. In that condition, how much value of air we are going to receive in our lungs, how much volume of air that to be hold in our lungs, how much volume amount of air that to be exhale out. So all these things to be considered. The volume of air that received into the lungs, hold into the lungs and exhale from the lungs to atmosphere at the time of ventilation in different conditions of a person referred as pulmonary volume. Follow student, there is the definition of pulmonary volume. It is very easy. Remember, if you understand pulmonary volumes, automatically you have to get good idea on pulmonary capacities. Why? Because definitely questions ask in entrance examination from pulmonary volumes and capacities. So you have to follow this, you have to observe the visual clearly and try to understand. So these are also called respiratory volumes. Remember, the pulmonary volumes also referred as respiratory volumes. The combination of two or more pulmonary volumes gave rise to pulmonary capacities. Students, try to understand here. The common, these pulmonary volumes also termed as respiratory volumes. So how can we attain pulmonary capacities? Pulmonary capacity is nothing but the combination of two or more pulmonary volumes gave rise pulmonary capacities. Suppose if we add the values of two pulmonary values, that give one kind of pulmonary capacity. If more than two pulmonary volumes involved, that gave rise one more pulmonary capacity, like that. So the addition of pulmonary volumes gave rise pulmonary capacity. So we attain pulmonary capacity by adding the pulmonary volumes. Follow? That is pulmonary capacity. So the pulmonary capacity is derived from pulmonary volumes. Follow? Right. Next, let us discuss the types of pulmonary volumes in detail. The pulmonary volumes are two variants. The first one is static pulmonary volume and second variant is dynamic pulmonary volume. What is static pulmonary volume? It is very simple. In case of static pulmonary volume, we can consider the, we won't consider the time. These are measured without consideration of the time. Remember, students. Next, what about dynamic pulmonary volume? In case of dynamic pulmonary volume, we can consider the time. These are measured by considering the time. In case of static pulmonary volumes, without considering time, we can measure. So that is difference. So the pulmonary volumes are two variants. One is static pulmonary volume and second one dynamic pulmonary volume. Followed? Right. Let us see how many variants of pulmonary, static pulmonary volumes are present. Four variants of static pulmonary volumes are present. Number one, tidal value. It represented with the abbreviated form, that is TV. In entrance examination also gives the Question in abbreviated form TV means tidal value. Right, next inspiratory reservoir, it abbreviated form IRV, inspiratory reserve volume. And third one, expiratory reserve volume, abbreviated form ERV. And residual volume, it's abbreviated form RV. Follow? So the static pulmonary volumes are how many? Four variants of static pulmonary volumes are present. They are tidal volume, inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume, and residual volume. You have to note down their representations: TV, IRV, ERV, and RV. Followed, right, students? Next, in detail, we will discuss about each and every static pulmonary volume. Among them, first one, tidal volume. What is tidal volume? The volume of air that passes along respiratory tract during inspiration and expiration, called tidal volume. Followed? So what is mean tidal volume? Did you got idea? The volume of air, how much amount of air, the how much quantity of air that runs along our respiratory tract at the time of inspiration and expiration in normal condition, in healthy person, that is considered as tidal volume. Follow? So the tidal volume is about 500 ml. So every pulmonary volume, numerical values are very, very important. You have to by heart them. The tidal volume is about 500 ml. Followed? You observe the graphical representation of tidal volume. In spirogram, you have to focus the yellow color bar. In the yellow color bar, the moderate upward downward curves are there. The upward downward curves, you observe, are marked in circle. Upward and downward curves are there. That upward downward curves represents the tidal volume in which both inspiration and expiration related volume airs are furnished in this, in that graphical representation. Followed? So that is a tidal volume. So concern to tidal volume, you have to observe the graphical representation at middle bar, yellow color bar. You have to observe. I am marked in the visual with red color circle, and you observe this is tidal volume, that is bar of tidal volume. How much tidal volume? It is 500 ml. That is the value of tidal volume. Next, we will discuss about minute volume related to tidal volume. What is minute volume? If the tidal volume calculated per minute, it is called minute volume. Followed? Suppose if we calculated the tidal volume up to minute, 1 minute, that is called minute volume. So the minute volume formula, you remember, the minute volume equal to tidal volume into number of breaths per minute. So let us derive the minute volume. How much minute volume of human being? The tidal volume value, what is the value of tidal volume, students? We learned it already, that is 500 ml, isn't it? So the tidal volume value is 500 ml, and number of breaths per minute, how much already we learned? That is 12 to 16 times or 14 to 18 times. So it is average value 12 to 18 times per minute. If we multiply them, we get minute volume that is 6000 to 8000 ml. Followed. So 500 into 12, 6000, like that. So 6000 to 8000 ml, otherwise 6 liter to 8 liter amount of air is minute value. Hello. So you got idea difference between tidal volume and minute volume. So if we calculated per minute, so that is minute volume, right? Next, one more pulmonary volume, that is inspiratory reserve volume, represented with I or V. The what is the inspiratory reserve volume? The additional amount of air that inhaled during forcible inspiration, called IRV. Students, you remember the inspiratory reserve volume related to forcible inspiration. So sometimes in special condition, we can inhale more amount of air into our lungs by forcible respiration. At that time, already I told, at that time the abdominal muscles plays key role. And next, the internal intercostal muscles involve in that phenomena. Followed. So in that special condition, we can inhale additional amount of air into our lungs. Followed. So that additional amount of air that inhaled during forcible inspiration called IRV. Followed. Right, students? You observe this graphical representation. So you have to observe which curve represents the IRV. Above the yellow color bar, brown color bar is there. I earmarked inspiratory reserve volume. You observe, you have to focus. This bar represents inspiratory reserve volume. This is upward curve. So you observe blue color arrow, that represents tidal volume. The such curves are concerned to tidal volume. And you observe, now you observe green color arrow. This curve represents inspiratory reserve volume. Followed. So this bar, you observe, this bar represents IRV. You have to focus on bars and curves, the pattern of curve you have to observe. And you see this circle are marked with the red circle. So that is upward curve related to inspiratory reserve volume. So this is inspiratory reserve volume. What is the value of inspiratory reserve volume? You observe 3000 ml. The inspiratory reserve volume is 3000 ml, 3 liters. Tidal volume is very simple, 500 ml, half liter. But inspiratory reserve volume is 3000 ml, 3 liters, beyond the tidal volume. How much amount of air that we inhale, you have to assume, right? Next, expiratory reserve volume, ERV. So you have to focus on name, expiratory reserve volume. So this pulmonary volume related to expiration process, isn't it? What is expiratory reserve volume? The additional volume of air that exhaled out, that expired out. So how much additional amount of air we are exhale out from our lungs during forcible expiration. It is also related to forcible expiration. Remember, students, IRV related to forcible inspiration, ERV related to forcible expiration. Followed. So the additional volume of air that expired out during forcible expiration called ERV or expiratory reserve volume. You have to focus the graph. graphical representation spirogram, the blue color bar represents the expiratory reserve volume. You have to observe the curve pattern. It is downward pattern. You observe always the downward curve represents expiration. They related to expiration. So you observe blue color arrow that represents tidal volume, normal curves, and next you observe pink color arrow that bar represents expiratory reserve volume. On that bar, the curve you have to observe. Now you observe blue color circle unmarked curve represents the volume of air consent to expiratory reserve volume. The expiratory reserve volume, you observe this is expiratory reserve volume. The expiratory reserve volume about 1100 ml. Follow? So what is the value of expiratory reserve volume? 1100 ml. You compare IRV and ERV now. So IRV is 3000 ml, ERV is 1100 ml. So always the inspiratory pulmonary volumes are greater than expiratory pulmonary volumes, because whatever amount of air we inhaled, among that volume of air, some amount of air consumed by us, that transported to the tissues and cells. That's why always the expiratory pulmonary volumes lesser than inspiratory reserve volume. Follow, students? Right. Next, one more static pulmonary volume, that is residual volume. Very, very important. It represented by RV. What is RV? It is nothing but the volume of air that remained still in the lungs after forcible expiration. That is called residual volume. Follow, students? So suppose we done forcible expiration, complete air we expel out, even though in our lungs still the air remain in our lungs. So how much amount of air remain in our lungs, that quantity of air related to residual volume. Understood? So the volume of air that remains still in the lungs after forcible expiration called residual volume. Right, students? You observe the graphical representation. You have to focus on violet color bar. There are no upward and downward curves. So that bar represents the residual volume. No curves are there. Means that air not coming out, not entering in. So no curves are there. So always that air still remains in the lungs. You observe arrow the tidal volume curves. Next, you observe pink color arrow, that bar represents a residual volume, right? Next, you observe this part and mark with circle, that is residual volume. The residual volume, how much? 1200 ml. Students, remember the numerical values of the pulmonary volumes are very, very important, ask in entrance examination. So it is about 1200 ml. Followed? Next, the residual volume is 1200 ml. So we got idea about static pulmonary volumes. You observe that spirogram, the tidal volume curves are there, IRV curves, ERV curves, and at the base residual volume placed, right? Next, the tidal volume value 500 ml, IRV 3000, ERV 1100, and the residual value 1200 ml, right? So pulmonary volumes we finish. We learn about pulmonary capacities. So how we attain pulmonary capacities? They are derived by the combination of two or more pulmonary volumes. They call pulmonary capacity. By addition of pulmonary volumes, we get pulmonary capacity. Already we learned four variants of pulmonary volumes. Among these four variant of pulmonary volume, any of two or any of more than two, if we added, automatically we attain pulmonary capacity, different pulmonary capacities. So let us see, these are five kinds. They are, you observe, inspiratory capacity represented with IC related with inspiration. Remember, whatever volumes involve in pulmonary capacity, according to that you have to trace out. Inspiratory capacity means related to inspiration. So the pulmonary volumes related to inspiration can involve in inspiratory capacity, right? Right. Second variant is expiratory capacity represented with EC. And next, functional residual capacity represented with FRC. And vital capacity, otherwise vital capacity, represented with the VC. And total lung capacity, TLC. So five variants of pulmonary capacities are there. Followed, they are inspiratory capacity, expiratory capacity, functional residual capacity, vital capacity, and total lung capacity. Let us discuss about each and every pulmonary capacity in detail. So first one, inspiratory capacity. So it is the total volume of air that a person can inhale after the normal expiration called inspiratory capacity. So the total amount of air, how much the person can inhale after normal expiration, including the tidal volume. So that is called inspiratory capacity. So the inspiratory capacity, IC, we attain by addition of two pulmonary volumes. They are tidal volume and inspiratory reserve volume. So it includes how many pulmonary volumes? Two pulmonary volumes. One is tidal volume and second one is inspiratory reserve volume. You observe yellow color bar, yellow color arrow, in which tidal volume is present and as well as inspiratory reserve volume is present. So by addition of these two, we attain what? Inspiratory capacity. Followed. So let us derive inspiratory capacity, IC. So inspiratory capacity include two pulmonary volumes, namely tidal volume and IRV. Right? So the inspiratory capacity equal to tidal volume plus IRV. Simple formula. It is the addition, combination. Inspiratory capacity nothing but inspiratory capacity equal to tidal volume plus IRV. Alright. So what is the value of tidal volume? 500 ml. Followed. And what is the value of IRV? So that is 3000 ml. Followed. If we add these two numerical values, we get inspiratory capacity, that is how much? 3500 ml. So that is the phenomena of getting pulmonary capacities. You have to remember the equations in entrance examinations. Compulsory ask these problematic question based on pulmonary capacities. So have students, you have to remember the principles, application principles of each and every pulmonary capacity. Among the, for example, in inspiratory capacity equal to tidal volume plus IRV. Three components are there. So in entrance examination, in problem, they gives two components and ask, trace out the one more component. For example, gives the value of inspiratory capacity and IRV and
ask the trace of the TV. So then automatically you have to change the equation, you have to change the principle. So the TV equal to inspiratory capacity minus IRV, like that. Follow? So suppose entrance examination asked about IRV, so IRV equal to inspiratory capacity minus what TV, like that. So in that way the questions may raise in entrance examination. That's why you have to remember pulmonary values and application of all these principles. Let us see one more capacity, that is expiratory capacity related to expiration. It is the total volume of air that a person can exhale after the normal respiration called expiratory capacity. So related to expiration, remember, so the amount of air that a person can exhale after a normal inspiration, that is called expiratory capacity. It also includes two pulmonary volumes, they are tidal volume and expiratory reserve volume. So expiratory capacity related to expiration, so that's why you observe the pulmonary value, expiratory reserve volume involving here, not inspiratory reserve volume involving here. So consent to related to inspiration and expiration, the components to be pulmonary volumes to be involved. So the expiratory capacity include tidal volume and expiratory reserve volume. You observe the graphical representation. So what components are present in expiratory reserve volume? Both the tidal volume and as well as expiratory reserve volume is placed. Alright. So it includes two pulmonary volumes. Let us derive the expiratory capacity numerical value. The expiratory capacity EC equal to tidal volume plus expiratory reserve volume. What is the value of tidal volume? It is how much? So it is 500 ml. And what is the value of ERV? Yes, students, how much it is? So it is 1100 ml. So by addition of these two, we get expiratory capacity, that is 1600 ml. Follow? Right. Next, functional residual capacity, FRC. What is functional residual capacity? It is volume of air that remained in the lungs after the normal expiration called functional residual capacity. So it includes residual volume and expiratory reserve volume. The volume of air, the amount of air that remained in the lungs, remember. So it includes both residual volume, expiratory reserve volume. Whatever air retained in the lungs still, that consent to residual volume. So automatically, residual volume component to be involved in it. So it includes residual volume and expiratory reserve volume. You observe this graphical representation. At the base, violet color bar, residual volume, green color bar, expiratory reserve volume. By adding these two values, we get functional residual capacity, FRC. So the FRC derived as this fashion. The FRC equal to residual volume plus ERV. What is the value of residual volume? It is 1200 ml. What is the value of ERV? It is 1100 ml. So if we add these two numerical values, get functional residual capacity. That is how much? 2300 ml. That is functional residual capacity. Followed. Right. Next, vital capacity. The vital capacity is, remember students, the vital capacity related to both inspiration process and as well as expiration process. So what is vital capacity? Two definitions are there. The first one we'll discuss for maximum amount of air that a person can breathe into the lungs after forcible expiration called vital capacity. So the how much amount of air the person can breathe in our lungs after completion forcible expiration. So it related to inspiration. And next, one more definition you observe, the maximum amount of air a person can expel out after forcible inspiration called vital capacity. So it include expiration process. The first one include inspiration process, followed. So the vital capacity related to both inspiration process and expiration processes. So after completion forcible expiration, how much amount of air to be inhaled, and after forcible inspiration, how much amount of air to be exhaled out. These two things to be considered in vital capacity. The vital capacity include three components other than residual volume. This is the easy technique to remember. Four components are there, four pulmonary volumes are there. In vital capacity, residual volume never involves other than residual volume. Three components to be involved, they are IRV, tidal volume, and expiratory reserve volume. Followed. Right, students, you observe the graph, spirogram. So that upward curve represents what? IRV. Right? Next, these middle curves represents what? Tidal volume. And next, you observe these curves represents what? ERV. So three components are there other than residual volume. Residual volume never involved here. So by adding these three pulmonary volumes, we get vital capacity. All right. So this is vital capacity. Let's see derivation of vital capacity. The vital capacity derived by addition of inspiratory reserve volume, tidal volume, and expiratory reserve volume. So the vital capacity principle equal to IRV plus TV plus ERV. What is the value of IRV, students? IRV how much? 3000 ml. What is the value of TV? 500 ml. Followed. What is the value of ERV? 1100 ml. Followed. So by adding all these three pulmonary values, we get vital capacity, that is 4600 ml. More than 4.5 liter. Followed. The last and final pulmonary capacity, that is total lung capacity. Right, the maximum volume of air that can accommodated in our lungs after maximum inspiration called total lung capacity. For example, at the time of doing yoga, pranayama, you have to observe, we can inhale more amount of air into our lungs as longer period. So at that time, total how much volume of air that accommodated in our lung. So that represents total lung capacity. Alright. So the total lung capacity is nothing but the maximum amount of air that can accommodated in our lungs after maximum inspiration called total lung capacity. So it include all pulmonary values. Simple. We have four pulmonary valves. All pulmonary volumes going to involve in total lung capacity. So the total lung capacity include all pulmonary volumes, namely tidal volume, right? Next, IRV, next, ERV, and next, residual volume. Hello. So all these four pulmonary volumes gave rise to total lung capacity. Follow? Let us derive total lung capacity. It is produced by addition of four values. So the total lung capacity equal to IRV plus tidal volume plus ERV plus RV. So the, what is the value of IRV? 3000 ml. What is the value of TV? 500 ml. What is the value of ERV? 1100 ml. And what is the value of RV? 1200 ml. By the addition of all these numerical values, we get total lung capacity, that is 5800 ml. It is near about 6 liters. Follow it, students? So our total lung capacity equal to 5800 ml. So with this, we finished pulmonary capacities. Now you have to practice the pulmonary volumes first and remember the numerical values of the pulmonary volumes, and afterward you have to learn the principles of pulmonary capacities, and then you have to apply all these things in problems. Follow? So with this, we completed pulmonary volumes and pulmonary capacities. Next class,